It's Karita of She Tried It, and welcome back. This is the Daylight Cardigan by All About Ami, I believe it's pronounced. That's, her name is not Amy, but it used to be All About Ami Gurumi. I will show her Instagram over here, but she mainly does a bunch of sweaters, cardigans, accessories, just a bunch of free patterns on her website. And this is one of them. I did customize it, and I'll get into that in a little bit, but I absolutely love this sweater. It's so cozy. So let me start with the reason that I made this sweater. I'm gonna show you a picture of the work sweater that I have right now. So work sweater, meaning I leave this sweater at work and I wear it when I'm at work. And this sweater has a huge hole in it on the elbow. And every time I talk to someone or wave at someone, they look at my elbow and they're like, what's wrong with your sweater? So I was like, you know what? I am going to make my own sweater now that I can. And I have been working on this sweater for the longest. So I don't know if you remember back when I made the Etta bag by We Are Knitters, but in the picture I was knitting something from the bag. And in that picture, what I'm knitting is the start of this sweater. So this sweater did take me a while. I kept stopping on it. I didn't consistently go with it. And I was like, you know what? It's gonna be one of the first things I make in the next year. So I have finally made it. But let's talk about the yarn. The yarn is Big Twist Classic. I believe this yarn can only be purchased from Joann, so you have to get it from there. Be sure to purchase Big Twist Classic because they have a ton of them. Big Twist Soft, Big Twist, I don't know, they have a ton of them. So just make sure it says Big Twist Classic. Like I said, it's only at Joann and it's 100% acrylic. This yarn is very, 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 very soft. I actually just took it out of the washing machine. So I guess that's technically, it's been blocked, but I really, really like this yarn. You've seen me make quite a few things with Big Twist Classic, which I've gone over in past videos, but I love this yarn and I'll be making more stuff because I have a ton of yarn left. Like I said, this is a free pattern on All About Ami's website. It comes in sizes small to 5XL, which I think is pretty size inclusive. Hopefully you agree. That's a ton of sizes. And when I say it comes in those sizes, I mean like she tells you how many stitches to do. So it's a pretty, I think a pretty thorough free pattern. I've never seen that type of free pattern on a website. But then again, I'm not always looking for free patterns. So maybe this is pretty common. But typically what I see is someone, a designer will make a pattern in their size and they'll show you how to customize it to your size, which is fine. But this is specifically written for from size small to size 5XL, which I think is really, really amazing. She has a bunch of free patterns on her website, but I will be linking this one down below. Feel free to go through her website. If you don't really like this cardigan, granted, I did not make it to look like her cardigan. I'll show a picture of hers. But if you don't like what I did with this cardigan, you can definitely do it the way that she actually wrote it to be. Or you can do one of her other cardigans. It seems like she is a lover of designing cardigans, so she has tons to choose from. And yeah, she has a great, great website. In terms of the modifications I did, there were quite a few. On her pattern, she tells you to go a length of 79 rows for the front panels and the back panel. I didn't do that because I wanted to be a bit more, as you can see, cropped. I wanted to stop like right at my waist. So I went 120 rows on my cardigan. And I didn't add the pockets. Hers does have pockets. Because I had it cropped, I figured that whatever pants I was wearing would probably have pockets. So I didn't really need the pockets on the sweater. I would just use the pockets in the pants that I was wearing. And yeah, that's pretty much all the modifications that I did. For the most part, I pretty closely followed her pattern because I don't know how to knit a sweater. This is the first cardigan I've ever made. Picking up stitches along the collar was different, but I did it. And I really like how it turned out. I guess one other modification is I added this little brooch. I'll leave this link below too. This is just from Amazon. I thought it would give it a little bit of flair because I knew I was doing it in this gray color. I like pictured me wearing it with a white shirt and jeans and just this like little brooch. I think it's really cute. I will be wearing this outfit to work. I think this is nice. But yeah, super comfortable cardigan. It will replace my old work cardigan, but honestly, I like this one a lot, so I'll be wearing it more than just work. So it'll just be my everyday cardigan. I love this thing, and I love that what the brooch adds, so it's super cute. But if you have any comments or questions on the pattern, I would definitely reach out to her for questions on the pattern. But if you have any comments, definitely leave them below. I will be back with another pattern in the future. I can't get over this. I can't believe I knit a cardigan. I will say that In the future, I do want to try different ways to knit a cardigan. There are certain like seams, you can kind of see it's really bunchy here, and I'm sure that's my fault. I don't know what I did, but it's a bit bunchy here, and maybe that'll like loosen up as time goes on, but I'm super fine with it. I love how it's kind of like a drop sleeve looked. I'm in love with this cardigan. It's perfect. The length of the sleeves are perfect. It is everything I wanted. So if you like it, let me know below and be sure to subscribe. And as always, I will leave a link to the pattern in the description box below. This yarn, I will have a little bit extra, but as I do, I don't know that I've really said this in my other videos, but as I do with almost all my patterns, I try to leave a link to my yarn stash. So if I don't use all the yarn, and if I can't send it back to the company that either sent it to me or I can't return it to the company I bought it from, I will sell the yarn. And I sell it on a website called Mercari. I sell a bunch of stuff on Mercari. But what I do is that the lowest price you can make a listing on Mercari is $5. So I have to make it $5. But I really am just selling my yarn for like $1 to $2 a skein or whatever I have left. And I will basically just ask that you cover the shipping. So the $5 isn't really the cost of the yarn. Like if you get like 4 or 5 skeins of yarn, it'll just be that one cost of shipping and then like a dollar for each skein. So I think it's a really, really good deal. I would definitely check out my Mercari store in the description box below. But I've talked enough. I love the Daylight cardigan. If you've made this, if you'd like to make this, definitely let me know in the comments below and I'll be back in the next video. Bye. Thank you.